Healthy welcome to everyone present here. I am Priyadeshni from Excel College of Physiotherapy and Research Center, Salem, Tamil Nadu. First of all, I would like to thank the organizer to give me this opportunity. Then I would like to thank my principal sir, Dr. Ayappan, MPT Neuro, and my dear staffs. As a final year student, very soon I am going to submit going to prepare my final year project, which was research based. In this quarantine, I am searching details for it. On the time, I got idea, why not we talk about this here? Because so many students are confused in that. Which when I'm talk about this, you have some ideas on that, and it was more useful to add some more steps to my knowledge. That's why I'm choose this topic. And today my topic was evidence-based practice in physiotherapy. Before I'm getting to my topic, I say some words about evidence. Which in this world, everything or anything without evidence was dismissed without evidence. Well, anything or everything in this world need an evidence. For example, anything which is asserted without evidence, it will be soon dismissed without evidence. So we need evidence for everything in this world. Except the God. We have trust in God, but we don't have any evidence for that. But we still trust in Him. Now the topic was evidence-based practice. Before I enter into my topic, first of all, what is study and research? If I am say I am studying means I am just go through what is already there. It's known as studying. Say I am doing some researches, it means I am creating a new ideas or new knowledge. It means creating a new thing. So in education point of view, we need to research more than study. Now, what is evidence-based practice? According to World Confederation of Physiotherapy, 1996, the commitment to use the available evidence. So we are committing ourselves to use those available evidences rather than any other myths or conventional therapies. We used those evidences to our decision making. In our field, the importance of decision making is from assessment to the entire treatment protocol. We need a decision making till the prognostic of the patient. So we are doing evidence based practice more than the practice based evidence. In final year, we do the project to creating something new in our field. Now, evidence-based practice is not only evidence for practice, it is a base for everything we do. It is nothing but a triad of clinical experience and available evidence. Then third one is integrating with the patient values and preferences. By making these three things into vital thing, we need to make our decision to get a treatment effective manner. These decisions are in three different parts. One is patient reported, second one is clinician observed, and third one is research derived. Okay, these are the three types of evidence. One is patient reported. It's nothing but we need to give some questions to the patient and make them to answer by themselves. Then second one is clinician observed. For example, if any patient come to us, we need to fix some protocol and we need to observe the efficacy of the treatment. It's known as clinician observed. Then last one is research based. We are go through more articles in online. In that articles, there was some researchers tell about the effectiveness and efficacy of some of the treatment. it was evidence of research derived evidences. Before we do any research, we need to undergo the following 5 steps. That means 5 A's of research. First one is ask, second one is acquire, third one is apply, third one is apprise, fourth one is apply, and fifth one is audit. Ask is nothing but it means formulating answerable questions. We need to first make a question. We need to ask anything. We need to think about anything. It is very much useful to get any other questions. From all of us, we need to ask a question to make some researches. As we know, if a staff take a class, so many unanswerable questions are there in our mind. We need to make them notes. It was useful for this research purpose. Then if we chat with our friends, we got so many idiotic questions. These idiotic questions are gone up to the further future research point of view. Then we need to acquire. If once we get a valid question means then we move on to the next. But it is acquiring of information or get an survey about that questions. Then third one is apprise. Apprise is nothing but it means we need to rearrange or arrange those those acquired knowledge or information into a particular order to get a effective data. It's known as apprise. Then we need to apply. After this arranging and collecting those informations, we need to search which one is beneficial. If there is answer for that question, is already there is any answers for that question, we need to go through it. Then in this apply stage, we need to apply the valid treatment, whether it is effective or non-effective. This is research. We need to apply them to individual, and we need to get effective benefits. Then the final one is audit. Audit is nothing but analyze the effectiveness of treatment or therapy you insisted in that individual. It is the final stage. If you get an benefits with or if you get an answer for your question means you did it. If you not get a valid answer, then your research is seed for a future research. That's it. It is all 5 we need to go through before we get into our research. A vital thing to do a research is first and foremost is you need to awake a question. That is formulating an answerable question is a main thing in any research. I give some ideas to get these questions. First of all, we need to quit the duplicating the researchers. We need to do our own research. It's only very much beneficial, and it is a thing to create new ideas. So please avoid the duplicating the researchers. If you think deeply or if you think some idiotic things in your mind means you get a new creative questions within your mind. It is the question which you need to answerable by your research. Is what important to do the researches. Then you get questions from reading a lot of articles. If you time permits, you must need one article for a day is good to get knowledge about researchers. There are vast number of articles in online. The data databases which gives about researchers are PubMed and some PDFs are very much beneficial and very much useful to get knowledge about researchers, and also you get ideas from your campus when seeing a new patients. All patients are not same at all. So you need to find a different case and make them as a research for a future therapeutic value. Then in some case presentations or your college presentations are very much useful in that. Now there is some question in our mind as a student, why we need this research? And the answers are our therapy is a scientific approach. So we need these researchers for the following purposes. First, we need to have evidence for our therapy. Then we need to quit the trial and errors. Then we need to fix a standardized protocol. Then we need to promote our efficient in this medical field. Then we need to answer the questions in viva and exam sessions. The one important thing why we need this research means we need to justify our treatment. So as a student, we need to undergo these evidence-based, that is, we need to do our projects by own without duplicate others. If you do this without any duplications, you become an efficient therapist in future. So we have many types of researchers to do so. They are meta-analysis and systemic reviews, some case presentations, case studies, or important one is randomized controlled trials, or the types and various kinds of projects or research we need to undergo. The one is randomized controlled trial is one standardized one, and it is more beneficial for further reading. Now the conclusion of my talk is there was n number of questions with unanswered and n number of questions still not awakened from your mind. Hope my talk give you some ideas. First, you need to make questions which answered by you, or see your questions to answer by others. Need to answer or need to formulate a answerable question is must. Important thing is don't bother effort and null hypothesis. Do your research as a full whole soul. Don't think it is good or bad, whether I get an answer or not. You need to do it with the whole flesh of a soul. Okay. Then you don't bother to ask questions to anyone. Please ask questions and get an answer, or motivate others to get answer for that unanswerable questions in the world. And we are Indians, we are a little lack in research view. So many journals in our country are not accepted worldwide. So we are a future therapist. We need to succeed in that, and we need to take over our researchers to worldwide acceptance. This is my thought, and thank you for listening.